Even so, Lord, come quickly. This is my fervent prayer. For I caught a glimpse of glory, and I'm longing to be there.
The Son of Man appeared.
Even so, Lord, come quickly. This is my fervent prayer.
For I've caught a glimpse of glory, and I'm longing. I've caught a glimpse of glory, and I'm longing to be there. I have fixed my mind on another time, on another
Hyacinth, or dear beloved mother, wife, grandmother, sister, auntie, niece, friend, and alumna. Death leaves heartache, no one can heal. Memories are treasures, no one can steal. Your smile so bright, your deep love and affection inspired us all. You always are there to give a helping hand. You are the first to always call and ask, how can you be of help? Your heart so big, you cared for all. Kindness, love, gentleness, meekness, humility are some of the words we can use to describe you. You cared about so many things. You found fun in learning new things. You, Haya, are loved, unseen, unheard, but always near, still loved, still missed, and very dear.
This lonely road I've traveled has brought me to this place where a thousand anxious questions fill my mind. Please hide me in the shadow of your goodness and your grace. If ever I've needed you, Father, now is the time. Give me peace. Give me heaven's peace. I feel so small and weak, and I cry out desperately for strength in days ahead. Those nights when I need rest, I pray that you would bless the deepest part of me with heaven's perfect peace. It's hard for me to fathom the circumstance I face. I'm overwhelmed.
This evening, we welcome you to this memorial service for our friend. On the western shores today, it signals the close of another Sabbath when we in South Florida celebrated Alumni Day. It also sets on the life of a remarkable person whom we all loved in life and to whom we will in a few hours say farewell. We are at that moment in time, which we hope would never come. But there are situations in life over which we have no control. And this is one such. But thank God, God has it all in control and in his powerful hands. Yes, we shall miss Herbie's silvery, melodious voice singing for us. But we look forward to that time when we shall meet again. As President Fletcher would have said, we have gathered this evening to mingle our tears with Althea, Megan, Alexis, Mother Olive, and Sister Barbara, and scores of family members and friends as we memorialize a brother, a husband, a father, a son, a genuine friend, and lover of people. Herbie was one of those guys you could never dislike, no matter how you try. He has made such an impact on my own family. We shall miss him. When we came here to Miami 21 years ago, it was Herbie who secured the first employment for my wife at his workplace. Personally, on the occasions I would call on Herbie to drop me at the airport or to collect me, we used the opportunity to chat about so many things. You know, he had nothing bad to say about anyone. Don't stretch your thoughts. The program this evening is intended to offer consolation to the family through music, reflections by preselected individuals from different backgrounds, speaking of their relationship with Herbie, and concluding with brief, inspiring thoughts. So I invite you all this evening to enjoy, share, participate where you are indicated, and may this evening be inspiring and consoling to those of us who grieve the loss of Herbie. And so at this time, I will turn over to Othniel Scott.
treasure I have in this wonderful place, buried deep in the heart of my soul.
Good evening to everyone and welcome. I would love to extend a very warm welcome to everyone joining us this evening to pay tribute to a wonderful human being, a father, a husband, son, an uncle, and a friend to all. You know, Herbie was tall in stature, but he had a big heart and was very generous with his kindness. I recall meeting him at the Miami Temple Seventh-day Adventist Church, and he always had a great smile and a welcoming disposition. You know, as we meet this evening, the NCU South Florida chapter sends condolences to the Fletcher family, and please know that you are always in our prayers. We hope this program brings comfort to the family and also assurance that we will meet Herbie again in that great celestial morning. We are enjoying the music so far, and we're going to take a trip down memory lane. And we pray that this program is just a blessing to everyone. Thank you.
Herbie was one of a kind. And we're so delightful this evening, delighted that there are so many people who have joined us to pay their respects to this beautiful soul. Herbie was also a member of the board of the Educational Foundation for Children's Care, which operates a children's village in Jamaica for abandoned, abused, homeless children. It was one of Herbie's passions, to which he gave unqualified support. Because he cared so much for the dispossessed and the underprivileged, he followed his father's footsteps, who was a founding member of the same foundation and was one of our valued members to the time of his death. The family is asking that you support the EFCCI charity in his honor. So help us establish a monument to Herbie's cherished memory by making a generous donation to the children of the village. Tomorrow you will see on the program a QR code that you can scan. But if you need further information on how you can do so, you can go to PayPal, search for Educational Foundation for Children's Care, or the link is efcci.org, efcci.org. We want to memorialize Herbie in a very special way. And so this evening, not too many people get the chance to sing for their own memorial service. But we are being given a treat this evening as we go down memory lane and see the many ways Herbie has blessed the lives of so many with his music and also with his life. This evening, we give thanks to God for this man who has given so much in such a short time, lover of God, lover of people. And we pray for his family, that God will continue to lead and guide and supply the void that has been created in this, in their lives. And so we want to turn over back now to Dr. Jeffrey Thompson, and he will come in at this time. And I hope that's what the script is saying. Yes.
Dr. Wellington. So my wife joins me along with all the members of the Fort Lauderdale Seventh-day Adventist Church in conveying our condolences to Herbie's wife, to his children, to Sister Fletcher, and to all of those who are connected to this wonderful Christian gentleman. Let us lift our hearts to God in prayerful meditation. There is a place of quiet rest near to the heart of God, a place where sin cannot molest, near to the heart of God. O Jesus, blessed Redeemer, sent from the heart of God, hold us who wait before thee, near to the heart of God. Loving Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for the life of our dear brother Herbie Fletcher III. We thank you for every moment and every memory of love and joy that you bequeathed to us through him. We thank you, Father, for all of his good deeds. Surely, Herbie lived a good life, a life that was full of hope, a life that was full of happiness and laughter, love and joy through the good times, as well as even during the bad times. Lord, he was so special as a musician, as a singer, always using his talents on the campus of Northern Caribbean University to spread joy to others through the power of singing. He lived a life worthy of emulation. And so, Father, we just want to thank you for the many lives he impacted during his 61 years. We thank you for the rest in Christ that he now enjoys. Thank you for giving him to us. And especially, Father, we want to lift up his children and family before you, especially his dear wife, who stood by him in sickness and in health. Dear Lord, I just pray in the name of Jesus that you will comfort this family in their loss, hold them in their sorrow and sustain them through their grief. Enfold them with all of your love that they may rest within your arms. Watch over their sleep every night and take their hands every morning as they face the dawn and the challenges of a new day. Lord, bind their hearts as one and bless their relationships. May they be united in their loss, but also bless them with smiles and goodness and help them to reflect on the happy times, the many vacations that they took together, the pictures that they took together, the memories etched on their minds forever. Help them to focus on those positive things. And then, Lord, lead this precious family onward to embrace life together. Help them to hold on to the promises of the Bible. Yes, help them to recall passages like the one found in the book of Romans. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are counted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. Yes, for I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Lord, hear our prayers, because we ask it in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the blessed Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. Amen. I would like to, at this time, bring in one of Herbie's very good friends, Dr. Olive Hemmings. I'm sure she's ready to say her piece.
No, sorry, I'm not Herbie's friend. I only knew him as someone. He was just graduating. Maybe the year I came in, he's the year he was leaving.
He was leaving. Ah, okay. But I'm sure you were able to relate to him somehow.
Oh, definitely. He was he was just a beautiful person. Observing him from a distance, he was even now, as I listen to him sing with his family, you just see that beauty shining through. And God is good, and we should never be discouraged when we see those who have lived these lives of service. We should never be discouraged, but we should keep pressing on, knowing that we live by hope. We do not hope in what we do not know. Hope is a knowing, a deep knowing. This is the same hope with which we set our alarm clocks, even though we know we'll not rise tomorrow. So let me read a few texts from the scripture, just texts of assurance and hope in God. I'll read one from Isaiah 49:9-10, 9b-10, one from 2 Corinthians 4:16, verse 5, a few from there in Romans 9:37-39. You are my servant. I have chosen you and not cast you off. Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be afraid, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my victorious right hand.
Mm-hmm.
So we do not lose heart. Even though our outer nature is wasting away, our inner nature is being renewed day by day. For this slight momentary affliction is preparing us for an eternal weight of glory beyond all measure. Because we look not at what can be seen, but at what cannot be seen. Yeah. For what can be seen is temporary, but what cannot be seen is eternal. For we know that if the earthly tent we live in is destroyed, we have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. For in this tent we groan, longing to be clothed with our heavenly dwelling. If indeed, when we have taken it off, we will not be found naked. What then are we to say about these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He did not withhold his own son, but gave him up for all of us. Will he not, with him, also give us everything else? Who will bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, yes, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? No, in all of these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I'm convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. You are my servant. I have chosen you and not cast you off. Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be afraid, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my victorious right hand. May God bless the hearts of those who survive my brother Herbert with these words. God bless you all.
Thank you so much, Dr. Hemmings. Those are truly well-chosen words of consolation, comfort, and hope. And so this evening, we really don't mourn as hopeless people. We have a great hope in Jesus Christ, our Lord. And so, Hannah, now one I know who knows Herbie very well, will now give us an item, special music. I walk today where Jesus walked.
Today where Jesus walked in days of long ago, down each path he knew. With reverent step and slow, those little lanes, they have not changed. A sweet peace fills the air. I walk today where Jesus walked and felt his presence there. My pathway led through there. Where Jesus knelt, where all alone he prayed, the Garden of Gethsemane. My heart felt on afraid. I picked my heavy burden up and with him by my side, I climbed the hill of Calvary. I climbed the hill of Calvary. Where Jesus walked and felt him close as he walked with me, and he talked with me, and he tells me I am his own. And the joy we share as we tarry there, and I can feel him close to me.
Thank you so much for reminding us that we too need to walk each day where Jesus walked. And this is appropriate at this time to hear from our Federation President, Dr. Harold Clayton, one who has been doing such an excellent job in leading this Federation from strength to strength. And it is such a pleasure to have him serve And at this time, I invite Dr. Clayton to bring us a tribute from the NCU Alumni Federation.
Thank you very much, Dr. Wellington, and to the team and the leaders from the South Florida chapter for facilitating this evening's event. Certainly, the work of an alumni leader, we stand on the shoulders of many who have gone and who have laid the foundation for us. I want to indicate that when I began to serve as the president of the South Florida chapter, one of the persons that I called quite early, and that was back in 2000, was Herbie Fletcher. Herbie was so warm. Herbie gave me some of the most amazing tips, but something he shared with me, and it resonated so well. Alumni work cannot be authentic unless it's about relationships. Herbie manifested so much things about relationships. What it is, he was able to bridge relationships. Persons in the 60s, the 50s, 60s, 70s, right down into the 2000s. He was so relevant. And so one of the things I got very early from Herbie, somebody who served as the president of the South Florida chapter, is alumni will be lost if we do not foster relationships. Thank you, Herbie, for those tips. There are other amazing tips. I've been able to benefit through the life of my siblings, the leadership of his dad, Elder Fletcher, and also through my parents and close acquaintances. And I was also able to benefit from the work of Aunt Olive, Sister Fletcher, who would oftentimes bless us on that piano. Today, the loss is immense. But as we reflect on the legacy of Herbie, we can reflect on a man of integrity, a man that was committed to this university, NCU, and to the life and what it exemplified, relationships, support, and experiences. To his dear wife, who I should even share that while she was attending to Herbie, I recall last year made a call that we needed some volunteers to go out and serve others. And while Herbie would have loved to have been there, his wife quickly responded to volunteer. To the two beautiful daughters, Megan and Alexis, I want to assure you that as an alumni family, you're not alone. Herbie resonates in your heart. The life that Herbie lived is a life that's reflected in Romans 14, verse 8. Says, if we live, we live for the Lord. And if we die, we die for the Lord. So whether we live or die, we belong to the Lord. Very soon, one day, very soon, God himself will wipe away every tear from your eyes. There'll be no more death, no more mourning, no more crying. For the old order of things would have passed away. So on behalf of all the alumni chapters in North America, in the Caribbean, in the Atlantic Caribbean, in Jamaica, we say to you, extend our deepest condolences, and we say, hold your faith, Jesus soon will come. God bless you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Clayton, for those words of assurance. And we are so happy to have not only not only South Florida chapter here this evening, but we have representatives from various chapters, different places. And so this evening, we are going to listen to a poem from one of Herbie's classmates, I think, Hillary Ascalon, and then a poem from the New Jersey chapter before we get in some other reflection. So we'll take the poem and the special music.
If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break,
If you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light, give a light to the ones who've lost their way, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your hearts on your sleeve, and if you're trying to be the change you wanna see, and if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you.
Wow, isn't that beautiful? Thank you for those very thoughtful words. And they reflect so much the one who we memorialize this evening. Certainly, there's a place for people like Herbie. I'm going to invite four persons to follow each other in their tributes and their reflections. We have Jennifer Gray Brown, Dr. Pete Williams, Dr. Hugh Maynard Reed, and Dr. Nelson Dockery. We will take those reflections in that order. Brown, Williams, Maynard Reed, and Dockery. Is Jennifer on? Go ahead, Dr. Williams.
Good evening, everyone. First, my condolences to Herbie's family, Althea, Megan, and Alexis, Sister Fletcher, and Barbara, his sister. I am not so well known to the rest of the family, but Herbie and I, we crossed paths first in 1975 when I went to high school. Now, to understand his outsized impact on my life, I need to give you some background. I joined a high school in Form 3, coming from a parochial school, a church school, Campbell's Castle, located in a district called Windsor Forest. And that should resonate with some people. I'm coming to Mandeville from a small place. I had no friends. Most of the people in my high school class knew each other, having come up from Form 1 and also to West Indies College Primary School. Landing there in Form 3A with no friends, no social connections, I ran into Herbie, and he immediately drew a circle that took me in. Not an exclusive one, as others had, with their friends, but a circle that took me in. And from there on, throughout high school, we were side by side, sat next to each other, weathered many a storms. After high school, we sort of went our ways. I stayed back at West Indies College, worked with Dr. Herbert Thompson for 2 years. And then at the end of that, came to the United States. And I should say that even though we had gone apart, I still was able to call on Herbie to pick me up at the airport. The first city I landed in Florida, Herbie was there, picked me up. I stayed at his house for the night and then moved on to Alabama. His kindness, as everyone has expressed so far, cannot be fully stated. Back in the high school days, Herbie won. Gave my first ring binder. I came from a parochial school. I was used to little notebooks, never had a ring binder. He also gave me my first calculator. And so that quality of life, that kind of kind disposition, readiness to embrace others, readiness to give a hand of friendship and support, whatever I took, what just came naturally for him. And of course, that's a tribute to his parents, the milieu in which he grew up. Now, after college, we lost, after coming to the US, we kept in touch for a brief while, but as time came between us, we drifted apart. We reconnected somewhere in the mid 90s when I was in New York, and we kept in touch again for a while. Always, you could feel his smile over the phone. We shared where we had been, of thoughts about our families, and kept in touch by email over the next years. Again, time intervened and we separated somewhat and reconnected for the last time in February of 2016, when sadly we met up at the funeral of one of Herbie's associates, Dean Edwards. After that, we vowed to stay in touch, and we did for a while. And as time and life goes, that was not a consistent connection. And I share the blame for that. We sometimes hide behind our busyness. But here we are now, and there's no more time to say thank you, Herbie, for all that you've done. Thank you for being a friend when I needed one. Thank you for supporting me through the years. And as I reflect and hear the comments of everybody else, I know the truth of which people speak. I have experienced it. And it brings to mind a phrase I saw somewhere, that it is more important to be good than to be great. And Herbie was both a good person and a great person. And a, such a life leaves behind a legacy for all to follow. There's a fable that's written by a French airman in the First World War. It's called The Little Prince. And it tells a story about a little prince who befriended a fox against his better judgment. He was wary about making friendships because he knew they would be broken at some time. And so over time, the fox convinced him to be a friend. And so the prince befriended the fox. And of course, there was a day that came when it was time to say goodbye. And the prince began to protest and say, "This is why I didn't want to be a friend. I didn't want to befriend you." And began to cry. And the fox, with his wisdom, comforted him and said, "No, don't cry. Every time I see the wheat fields, I would remember your hair." Of course, he must have been blonde or something like that. And I will think of you. And for Herbie, every time there's an act of kindness, everything I do that may be kind to a person, wherever I see that, I will remember him, because that's his legacy and that can never be erased. I am grateful to have crossed paths with Herbie Fletcher in 1975, and his memory and his goodness, his greatness will live forever in my heart.
Thank you so much, Doc. Spoken your heart. Is Dr. Maynard Reed on? Not, we'll move on to Dr. Dockery. Okay.
Hello. I'm Steve Constantine, and I'm making this recording as a tribute to a dear friend and brother who passed away recently, Herbie Fletcher. And the context in which we were friends. Hello, I'm Steve Constantine, and I'm making this recording as a tribute to a dear friend and brother who passed away recently, Herbie Fletcher. So to Mother Olive, Sister Barbara, Herbie's wife and kids, please accept my deepest condolences on the passing of your beloved. My tribute to Herbie goes back to West Indies College and the context in which we were friends. He had involved many Sunday afternoons playing volleyball. And there were times we played as teammates, and some of the best games I've enjoyed playing with him and our other friend, Oswald Ruggles. They were by far the two most powerful hitters of the ball in our era. And me playing either backcourt or setter to either of these two powerful hitters was a real joy. And we enjoyed many a Sunday afternoons together with other teammates. I think of Dr. Orlando Moncrief as one of those teammates. There was a young lady from Panama who was a master at the game, Rena Amaro. We had lots of fun. And there were times when I would play on opposing teams to Herbie and Oswald. And I clearly remember one Sunday afternoon putting one of the best block shots I'd ever accomplished during competition at West Indies College. And it was against Herbie. And we almost made simultaneous contact with the ball. But if you know anything about Herbie, it was a very strong, powerful guy. And I was no match. My block was no match for the power of his hitting. And I have a memento that I've looked at over the years and smiled, that I will now treasure as a symbol of our friendship. Here it is. Pinky finger that broke that day, and it never quite healed back the way it should have. So my brother, my friend, this is a constant memory of the good times that we spent. And when I speak of Herbie's playing, he played with passion. He was a competitor of no mean order. And on any given Sunday, you could run into the hot hand of a Palti Shields or a Coco T or Danny Durrell, Paul Scovallo, or even Willie Oliver from back in those days. But none of these guys were as competitive or as consistent with the power heading as the duo of Oswald Ruggles and Herbie Fletcher. Those are my memories from those days. And when I met you, Herbie, for the last time in December of 2019, I could take note that life had been difficult in some ways, your physical setbacks. But one thing I noted in our time together is that at no point in time did I get the sense from you that you live life with any form of regret. You had a beautiful smile. We shared a few jokes together. And it was a pleasure to hang out with you after all those years. To the family, I say, as you grieve and as you mourn his passing, my prayer is that the memories of the good times will be the things that cheer you up in the midst of your grief and your sorrow. Know that we stand together with you with broken hearts over his loss and his passing. But we live in the hope, the Christian hope, that gives us all our joys, the promise of a new day in heaven. So, together with you, we mourn. But also, together with you, we share the thought and the joy that comes from knowing that we will get together in the art medium. And Herbie, maybe there's one more game left in both of us. They talk about heaven being the sea of glass. Maybe there's a sandy shore somewhere, and we can play yet another game and have some fun. So I join with the others, friends and family alike, in saying to the mom, to the sister, to his wife, and to his children, we pray that God bless you and strengthen you in the midst of your loss and your sorrow in this moment. God bless you. Bye, my colossal brother.
I know Herbie as a young fella that I connect with, that I can relate to. His mother, his father, his sister. And I am just left at a loss. And if it were not for the blessed hope, I would be an angry man. Mm-hmm. I would be a very angry man. For in the last 11 days, I know 11 friends who have died.
Wow.
In 11 days, 11. And Herbie, you know, I don't know how his mother has coped, because Herbie was such a son. Herbie was such a person. I knew him when he was a single young man, and to see him become a family man, a responsible man, who was always positive, who was always pleasant, who I don't ever remember seeing Herbie giving me any attitude. And I know that he must have had tough times, and he has been a source of strength, because amidst his difficulties, amidst his trials, amidst his tribulations, he took everything in stride, and he was always trusting in God. I can think that in the last stint to his hospital, his biggest concern was his mother. He didn't want her coming to the hospital and getting ill. He cared about his mother. It just reminds me of the story of Jesus. And he, on the cross, he says, "Woman, behold thy son." And Sister Fletcher and Barbara and Althea and the children, let us live faithful. Let us trust in God. Let us live and ask God to cover our weaknesses and give us strength so that we can see him again. I want to see Herbie again. Not only am I looking forward to seeing Herbie, I am looking forward to being in the kingdom with Bob Marley playing the guitar by Jesus' side. I'm not funny when I say that. I am looking forward to heaven to be such an exciting place. Dreadlocks Rasta and Herbie with the BMW. We won't be needing BMWs then, but it's going to be a wonderful place. And I say to all of us, friends, let us have faith. Let us have trust. And no matter what your problem is, let us hold on to the hem of his garment. He is not letting us go. Sister Fletcher, Barbara, and the rest of the family, hold fast. Hold fast, for it is God's will that we all be saved. I look forward to the kingdom. I look forward to seeing Herbie along with my many other friends. But most of all, I want to be there, even if I'm the last one in. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Doc, for those passionate words. Yes, I agree with you. Were it not for the blessed hope, we would have an angry nation. But, you know, we trust in God.
Yes.
And so after this music coming up by Dr. Christine Jobson, we will take Hillary, who is here with us. She will do her poem, Hillary Ascalon. And then we will take Pastor Dr. Paul Scavella in Reflections. Music, then we take that poem, and we're going to give a few moments in an open mic situation, and give a minute to anyone who would like to just have your thoughts expressed briefly before we bring the program to a close. And so, let's listen to Give Me Jesus.
What?
so beautiful. Only Jesus can suffice. Thank you so much, Christine. That was beautiful indeed. And so let me tell you who is coming next. I did say Hillary, and yes, Hillary will come. And then after Hillary, we'll have Susiana Cadro, and then Pastor Paul Scavella. So let's take them in that order. Hillary, Susiana, and Scavella.
Good evening, everyone. I'd like to pay this tribute to Lee Herbert Fletcher III, a dear friend of mine. A loving husband, a brother, a father, a friend, a dear son, a cousin. His connections had no end. Saddened, shocked, we all were when we got the word of the passing of our loved one, Lee Herbert Fletcher III. Many of us met him when we attended IIIC, whether in the music room, the play field, or the classroom like me. His closest buddies, Andrew, Johnny, Irwin, and Eddie Ashley, were inseparable, like quintuplets. They were the posse. A gentle giant who had the knack of putting others at ease. But on the volleyball court, boy, he was a beast. Here's the dream team who can attest to that. As many as Saturday night, he didn't take any slack. There was Oswald, Paul Price, Ernie Eden, and KP, Roy Ashmead, Mikey Thorpe, and of course, Coca T, Berlin Jimmy Wilson, and James Abegi, not to mention Pastor Moncrief, also known as Pugsley. Steve Constantine, I didn't forget about you, as you were part of this amazing crew. Of course, the ladies wouldn't be outdone, and Herbie made sure they didn't miss out on the fun. There was Juana Hutchinson, Donna Stubbs, Shirley Fletcher, and Sharon Jones. They were serious contenders, of that they made no bones. I may have missed a few of you and didn't call your name, but don't take it personally. It was only a friendly volleyball game. Herbie, as he was called by those who knew him well, was always warm and pleasant. Is upset, you could really tell. He played the trumpet, entertained us, sometimes had a lot to say. His laughter was infectious. We wouldn't want him any other way. For church, concerts, and weddings, Herbie would sing. His mellow tenor voice had a distinct ring. He sang in Agape, Allegra, and the well-known Love Herald's Quartet. Sadly, all four have now been taken by the enemy death. This wonderful guy who we all came to love, though big as a giant, was as harmless as a dove. His voice now silent. Oh, death, you won't have the last word on God's precious son, Lee Herbert Fletcher III.
Mm-hmm.
Should I go, Pastor Wellington?
Sure, sure. Yes.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Susiana Cadro, Susiana Shields, as I am known at IIIC Primary School, High School, and College. I will be reading the graduates of 1973 from the primary school where the famous Mrs. Dr. Merle Bennett was principal. And I will call their names because I and my sisters met Herbie Fletcher in 1973-72 when we came to West Indies College Primary School. So I will begin as the list says. And the first name on the list was Lee Herbert Fletcher III, Gloria Davis, Michael Reynolds, Gloria Graham, Corin McCoy, Maureen Newman, Thelma Chowers, Allison Thompson, Neville Hodges, Lesrine Bedford, Carlton Myers, who predeceased, Marlon Dawes, who is gone, Donnie Dowse, Carmen Francis, Jennifer Gray, Tom Scott, Orly Bury, Beverly Clayton, Paul James, Joy Thomas, Renee Scavella, Angela Davidson, Carol Bramwell, Beverly Broomfield, Nazarene Shields, Michael Andrews, Audrey Webb, Susanna Shields, myself, George Gates, Norris Gordon, Horatio Williams, Amitha Lewis, Narita Lewis, Amitha passed, Michael Lorman and Trevor Lorman, who left early, and Maureen Newman. Just remember those names. We all were in that famous grade 7 class together. So when I hear the stories of Herbie and what he is an adult, we have no clue, because we knew Herbie when he was a teenager, 13, 10, 11 years old. So I can talk about those days. I can't talk about the things that I hear this afternoon, but I can talk about those days being in grade 7 in the primary school with Mrs. Merle Bennett. So Herbie was the cuddly bear who we had in that class. He was the defender of us girls in grade 7. The girls in that class knows who they are. I can name the names, but I would not do that. They are, we loved him so much. He was in our corner. All the girls in that grade 7 class, he was. And when the new girls came from the foreign countries, I can name them, he was their friend. He took them under his wings, and he cuddled them and nurtured them and bring us into those Jamaican girls' classrooms, into our society where we were. He was no fast runner. When we went out on the play field, on that gravel to play baseball, when Herbie was on our team or on the team that he chose, we were stressful because he was not a runner. But when he bat those ball, let me tell you, want him on your team to bat the ball, because he had power. He had power to bat those ball all the way over to the bakery, into that hole. So we enjoyed that with him. You know, he showed compassion. He in our classroom, to our classmates, he was. I remembered the year when my mom had a birthday party for me. And the only gift I got was from Herbie. The only gift. He brought, I don't know if he stole it from Mother Fletcher, but he brought me the perfume that I loved. And I still have the scent. I can still smell that scent because he brought me that perfume. And I still look for it and I buy it. Every now and again, I would put a little spray and I would remember Herbie, because he taught me how to love and show affection to each and every girl in his classroom in grade 7. So I remembered him. Herbie and I would talk over the years, and even before, when we were in primary school, comparing our appearance, because my mom was a chalk line lady. We had to walk on chalk line for her, and so was Pastor Fletcher. So we would compare notes as to who mother and whose father would do this. And we would laugh at the things they do. So we remember that that was a jovial time for us, to comparing our parents. And then a couple of years after that, I went to his dad's funeral, and we reconnected in Florida. And then we spoke over the years about our health challenges that we have. And every now and then I would call him. And the last time we spoke was about a couple months ago when he called to find out what's my husband's telephone number. Because you see, my husband was part of the Allegra at one time when he was at IIIC. And so he wanted to get connected with my husband, Cadro, Philip Cadro, with Andrew Reed, his best friend. And they connected and they talked for hours. I remember that conversation quite vividly. And so I will miss Herbie not having him to speak to occasionally. I will miss that. And I want to say to Mrs. Fletcher, we call her Miss Olive, Barbara, his sister, Althea, his wife, and his two lovely daughters, Megan and Alexis. I want to say to them, and I will go in part of the Jamaican vernacular as when I read it, so please forgive me. I want to say, if you want to cry, cry. Cry till you drop out. If you want to smile, smile. Smile at the hugs. Smile, remember the hugs that Herbie gave, those giant hugs, those bear hugs. Remember the smile, smile. If you want to laugh, laugh at his humor. Laugh at the jokes he gave you. Laugh till your belly button busts. Laugh, but heal in your own time. Heal in your own way. Heal in your time. Heal in your own way. I repeat it again. Heal in the time and remember all those wonderful, gracious, gorgeous things that Herbie did for you guys. Remember that. And as we laughed and as we smile, I am looking for that blessed hope. The blessed hope we are to look for when Jesus come, when we will see our loved one again. So Mrs. Fletcher, Barbara, Althea, Megan, and Alexis, take hope in that blessed hope.
Amen.
Amen. Go ahead, Doc.
Good evening to one and all. And it's certainly my pleasure to be able to share with you in this moment. And yet still we ache for the loss of our brother and friend. Herbie and I are what folk would often refer to as PKs, because we grew up in pastors' homes with our fathers as ministers of the gospel. And our acquaintance and knowledge of each other would have begun with our parents, our fathers in particular, traveling back and forth to Jamaica and the Bahamas, becoming acquainted with the families through our fathers. And so upon my arrival to college in 1975 in Mandeville, of course, I was embraced by the Fletcher family as one of my homes away from home. And knowing Pastor Fletcher made it the transition from home to college life, along with his wife and the children, Barbara and Herbie, a much more pleasant experience. When we talk about being friends, a number of things that are part of that. One is that you can find someone who you can trust, someone who cares, and someone who looks into your best interests. And certainly Herbie was one of those persons, because he sang and I also sang, and his mother played. I became a part of the college choir and everything that moved in terms of music. Our paths would become even tighter. he was in high school when I began college, and I could remember his energy. Certainly, he and Andrew Reed and Donnie Douse and others who moved together, they gravitated to a group of us as Bahamians, Kenny DeVoe, Nelson Dorsett, myself, and we would always find a way to have a good laugh, to share jokes and expressions of affection for each other. As I grew there on West Indies College campus, of course, I was a volleyball lover, and we would always have discussions about who would be the best team in volleyball, and Kokatee and I were always mostly on the same team, and Herbie and Oswald would be the opposers. And as Steve expressed, there were some fierce battles out there on the field on Saturday nights sometimes when there was no march by the seat of the scornful. We would be down on the field sometimes past the time that we should. And then because of our musical interests, the group Alegre came into being. And I never thought that I would be sitting here in a moment like this and reflecting on Alegre and recognizing that most of the male singers in that group have predeceased me. And I just look forward to a time when we will be able to be reunited in heaven. One of the songs that we used to love to sing was, "Sometimes when I am down and I don't feel like you're around, oh Lord, feeling so sorry for me, not knowing that all the while you're working for me." And you know, the Apostle Paul reminds us that in all things, when you consider it, everything is going to work out for the best interest of those who love Herbie, his wife, Althea, his daughters, Megan and Alexis, and their sister, Fletcher. That one day we'll see Herbie again, because we believe that he was faithful. The last time that I interacted with him in person was, well, 3 years ago in my doctoral program at NCU. And he had come home for a couple of days, a couple of weeks maybe. And we spent some time chatting and talking together and just reminiscing on the wonderful good times that we had. When Herbie was in high school, before he could get his license, I remember the make of the car. I think it was a Ford something. It was a green, lime green car. And Herbie just couldn't wait to get his license so that he could drive that car up and down. And before he could do that, of course, he had a permit that he would always be challenging his mother to get in the car with him so he could drive. And I watched Sister Fletcher sweat over that many times. But she was such a loving, caring parent, and being able to embrace all of Herbie. And so we give God thanks for those expressions of love between he and his parents, especially his mother during those times. As I reflect, I know that this gentle giant was one who loved the Lord, one who made God his choice. And you know, they often say that we PKs sometimes don't follow our parents. But I can tell you that there are more of us who do than those who don't. And Herbie certainly was one of those who loved Jesus. And I believe because of that, that one day we shall meet face to face and we shall behold him. We'll be able to sing, and Alegre will be able to get back together along with all of the other musical interests that we were involved in at WIC. And so I extend on behalf of my wife, Joan, and my family, my three adult children, our sincere condolences. And I just want to encourage you to be faithful. The Apostle John writes in Revelation 22, verse 12, And Jesus says, "And behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me to give everyone according to his work." May God, may we all experience that with Jesus and with Herbie in the earth made new. God bless you all.
Amen. Amen. We want to, we're so happy we did not miss Hillary's poem. Mm-hmm. Hillary, that was awesome. We treasure that.
You're welcome.
You to go back and dig up some of that history and put it so poetically, so beautiful. That's awesome. And Susanna, you also did a terrific job in giving us the early years of our friend Herbie. That's awesome. And Pastor Paul, you have reflected nicely on those days together, and we appreciate that. All right. We have two recorded tributes that we would like to bring in. And then we will only have time for maybe two open mic sessions because we are already past the time. We're scheduled to close and we need to bring this to a close. And we have a nice closing for you. So we don't want you to leave us. All right, so let's take those two recorded tributes and then we will have one or two opportunities for those who were not scheduled on the program.
Good evening. It is my honor to be here with you this evening for this memorial service in honor of a very, very special individual, Herbie. He will truly be missed. I am honored to also present two songs this evening requested by Althea, and the first, Special Delivery, and the second that I will sing after I walk today where Jesus walked.
Never was anyone like him. Never will one be the same. Tiny babe, infant king, savior. We worship and honor the power of his name. Oh, he came special delivery, wrapped up in love, bound by a promise, sealed by a death and filled with the Spirit, carried by where he was going by the look on his face. Where he went, love was there also. Where he went, love showed the way. Those who saw knew he was holy. And I see what they saw to this very day. Going special delivery, wrapped up in love, bound by a promise, sealed by a dove and filled with a Spirit, carried by grace. He knew where he was going by the look on his face. When I'm called, I will go gladly. I will not grieve for the past, for I know where I'll be going, and I will be going to see him at last. I'm going special delivery, wrapped up in love, bound by a promise and sealed by a dove and filled with a spirit carried by grace. You'll know where I'll be going by the look on my face. Special delivery, wrapped up in love, bound by a promise and sealed by a dove and filled with a spirit carried by grace. You knew where he was going by the look on his face.
to be able to get on here. So if we have one or two persons who would like to quickly say something regarding your reflections on Herbie, just put up your hand on the reflection panel here so we can take you in. All right, let's see. Okay. All right. Don't see any hands, so we're going to put the cap on this evening's package. And indeed, Herbie was special delivery. From all that we had to say this evening, those who did not even know him well can understand that Herbie was one of a kind. What an amazing person Herbie was. And what a remarkable life he lived for all of us to emulate. I'm reminded in closing of a verse in scripture that I wish to apply to Herbie. It's Psalm 37 and verse 37. It says, "Mark the perfect man, and behold the upright, for the end of that man is peace. Megan and Alexis began the program by singing about peace, heavenly peace. I want to close on that note as well. I know Herbie wasn't perfect. Like you and myself, he made some mistakes. But he connected with a friend who is perfect and promised to absolve him of every guilt and every sin he ever committed. So Herbie was a good and upright man who stands among his peers as a monument to be observed, commanding attention and molding lives by his quiet influence. The end of life, rather than in any preceding stage, reveals character, and in the tests of the quality and impact of such a life. The end of the good man, says the scripture, is peace, because the good man would connect with the Prince of Peace. Peace in view of the past, as you look back. Peace in view towards the future, as we look to the future. A good life can bring only a perfect end. And so we look forward to the day when we will see Herbie singing in the heavenly choir, and you and I, some who could never turn a good tune down here, will also be part of that choir. I close with this sonnet by John Donne. Death, be not proud, though some have called thee mighty and dreadful, for thou art not so. For those whom thou thinkest thou dost overthrow, die not, poor death, nor yet canst thou kill me. From rest and sleep, which but thy pictures be, much pleasure, then from thee much more must flow. And soonest our best men will thee do go, with thee do go. Rest of their bones and soul's delivery, thou art slave to fate, chance, kings, and desperate men, and doth with poison, war, and sickness as well. And poppy or charms can make us sleep as well. And better than thy stroke, why swellest thou then? One short sleep, we wake eternally, and death shall be no more. Death, thou too shall die. And so, my friends, we close this evening with hope. And I'm sure in the last moments of the song, all we ask, heavenly song, you will see the information at the bottom of your screen, just reminding you to donate to the NCU Federation. We didn't take the time to tell you of the needs that have come our way. But we ask that you remember those that you have left behind by making a generous donation. And we'll ask Melcada to put up that, again, that little thing at the bottom, so folks can see how and where to donate. I'm going to close out with prayer, and then after that, we will go out with this special music, All We Ask. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for the time we have spent together this evening, memorializing and reflecting on the relationships that it was our privilege and our pleasure to share with one of your sons, who have given so much of himself to family and to friends and to your church in general. We thank you for the life that he lived. We thank you for the example that he has been to so many. We pray, O Lord, that you will now build a hedge and a shield around his family. Be with his mother. We know the hole that is in her heart at this time. We pray, O Lord, that you will surround her and encourage and strengthen her. Be with Althea, Megan, Alexis, and also Barbara and their families. We ask, Lord, that you will surround each one, give them courage, and tomorrow, especially when the final notes will be sung, we pray, Lord, that you will be there with them to bear them through on eagle's wings. Bless all those who have come on the platform this evening and have listened and shared their testimonies and reflections. May we all be faithful so that in your coming, we shall experience the joy of singing with Herbie again, since we ask it all in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Thank you, Pastor Willie.
Oh, thank you, Sister. Love to have you. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Special tribute to Mr. Brother Atnail Scott and the South Florida chapter for this program this evening. And so I turn over back to Scotty. I saw you come on. Don't know if you have anything to say to the folk. If not, we leave the platform open for a few minutes so that those who want to greet can do so.
That's nice, Pastor Wellington. I see some folks who I haven't seen in years on the platform. Some of Herbie's classmates, Michael Reynolds, my sister Nazreen, Maureen Newman, Norris Gordon, all of us were in his class in grade 7 at the primary school. So guys, if you want to shout out and turn your cameras on and stuff like that, so everybody can see you guys. We haven't seen Maureen in years and years, and she's here. This is Pastor Newman's daughter, so she's with us. And
hi.
And my sister Nazreen, Renee Scavella. So we have a good group of our classmates here on tonight. So guys, shout out and say something.
Hi, everyone.
Hello.
Hi, hello. Good to see you. Hillary, how are you?
Fine, thank you. Dr. Pete Williams, who was on earlier, but I don't see him now. I remember him very well. Wonderful, yeah, humble human being.
He's right there.
He's still there.
Pete is right there. Pete is right there. Neil, Rita, all of us.
Now I'm instead of Dr. Williams. Hi, Pete.
Hey, Hillary.
Shona, Levy. All of us were in class together with Herbie. So
yes, Hillary sat next to us.
Yes. Yeah, I sat with all those guys in class.
Good to see you, Hillary. Good to see you.
To see you too.
Hi, Pete.
Hello.
Joan, you have to turn on that camera, Joan.
Come on.
Hey, Pete, how are you doing? Norris.
Hey, Norris.
Hi, Norris.
Have you seen Maureen Newman, Norris? And where's Michael?
Maureen.
Hi.
Yes, Maureen Newman is right there, Norris, right there.
Yeah. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you too.
Yes.
Where's Michael?
Norris, I'll be down there next week. I'll see you.
And Ray.
Jamaica.
Hi, Pete. And
Norris is not in Jamaica.
I live in South Florida now, man.
Oh. My bad.
Hi, Norris. Hi, Nazreen.
Hi,
hello, Hillary. Hi, Pete. Hi, Norris. Good to see you guys.
Hi, Nazreen.
Hi, Nazreen.
Yes.
What's up?
Nothing much, Norris. And good to see you. And Pete, I guess I will see you, and condolences to you, Pete, on the passing of your brother.
Yeah,
thank
right.
you.
Yeah.
I will see you when you come down.
I will. I hope so.
So, Dr. Yes. Pete, you're going back to Campbell's Castle?
Oh, yes. Pastor Wellington, I remember you on your Austin Cambridge.
You remember that?
Pastor Wellington, how are you doing?
It's good to see you, Norris. I'm doing good.
Nice to see you, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, just as well. I remember you used to play the piano.
I used to play the fool around it, yeah.
Othniel, where's Beverly? Othniel, where's Beverly?
Hi, Norris.
Hey, hi. How are you?
Othniel, where's Bev? Where's Bev?
Susie. Susie.
Yes.
Thank you for the link.
You're most welcome. You know, going back all those years in grade 7, let me tell you, it's such a, yeah, I don't know what, it's such a sad to see that sad, our classmates, yeah, yeah. We are at the point in our lives now where our parents were when we were in that, and we are there. So
right.
let us just love one another and just, you know, be ready when our time come to exist on this road of life. So, and be prepared every day as we go along to see each other. What a glorious reunion that will be. So let us be ready, or let us prepare our lives and be ready for when our time comes to walk off that exit. So it's a nice thing and a blessing to see all of us here. And I wish everybody good health. Take care of yourself. Put God first in our lives as we navigate through this life.
Amen.
Thank you, Dan.
Amen.
Hi, Hillary.
Hi, Olive, how are you?
I'm good to see you. I know a lot of you, all you people on here, you know, I'm not in your league, so I'm just passing through. Have a go.
Hey, Pete. Yes.
Hey, Ray.
Hey, Ray.
Wow. How are you,
man? How you doing?
Hi, Austin.
Well, good to see you, man. Yes, man. Good to see you. I hope to connect with you. Susie has all the connections, all the contact numbers.
Excuse us. Abneel, where is Bev?
Just disappeared.
Scotty, we can't hear you.
We can't hear you. You're muted. We can't hear you,
Scotty. Well, he's unmuted, but I'm
going to
hear him.
All right, good night, everyone. A long way from home.
Just before you leave, Dr. Hemmings, Scotty is trying to say that they have a 70-second tribute for Herbie that came in a little late. So they want to play it, so you can watch that.
Okay.
All right, go ahead, Melcado, just put that on.
Fix my mind on another time, on another time. And here I mean to stand until God gives me more light. And my mind on another time, on another time. I have said my